During the financial crisis of 2008, one particular measure of risk became very popular. Many financiers and government officials started talking about expected shortfall. It designates the expected loss of a portfolio, in the worst, X percentage of cases. In this definition, X can be 1%, 0.5%, or even 0.1%. The idea is to use expected shortfall as the worst-case scenario, and possibly prepare for it. In this way, the expected shortfall can tell us what is the expected loss of a portfolio in the worst 1% of possible cases. Or, in another context, how much is a bank's expected loss if loans perform very, very badly, the worst 1% of cases? Here's an example. A portfolio manager decides that the expected shortfall they would like to communicate to clients is at 0.3%. With average historical returns of 7% and an average historical standard deviation of 9%, the portfolio manager estimates that the expected shortfall of 0.3% would be equal to its expected mean minus 3 times sigma. This gives us 7% minus 3 times 9%. The expected shortfall is minus 20%. I'm sure you guessed why we multiplied by 3. We are considering an event that has a 0.3% chance of happening. 99.7% of the observations in the normal distribution are being excluded. That's a 3 sigma event. And hence, we multiply by 3.